Hi there, and welcome to the Introduction to Algorithms in Swift course. My name is Chas Nistor, and I'd like to give you a brief overview about this course. Why should you learn algorithms in the first place? Computer algorithms have been developed and refined over the last couple of decades. The study of algorithms is fundamental to any programmer who plans to develop a software system that is scalable and performant. Once we got past the basic Hello World beginner applications, we begin to realize that complex apps require a different approach. The software, which used to work nicely during our tests, becomes incredibly slow and frequently crashes in real-world situations. The reason is that we haven't prepared our app for real-life usage. While it ran without issues with small datasets during our tests, it fails miserably when reality kicks in. Algorithms are indispensable to building software that is capable of managing large amounts of data or solving complex problems efficiently. Last but not least, chances are high that you'll encounter algorithm and data structure related questions during job interviews. I could list many other reasons why algorithms and data structures are so important to us, software developers. But let's rather jump to the next section and check out what we are going to cover in this course. Alright, so here are the main topics. First, I'm going to show you the power of algorithms. We'll compare simple, unoptimized samples with ones which rely on algorithms. If you had any doubts about the importance of algorithms, these examples are going to convince you. Next, we'll talk about the Big O notation, which is a mathematical model for measuring and classifying algorithms. It estimates the time efficiency of running an algorithm as a function of the input size. We are going to talk about linear time, logarithmic time, constant time, and polynomial time. To understand these concepts, we are going to implement, analyze, and compare a couple of algorithms. Then, we jump into the topic of basic sorting algorithms. We talk about insertion sort, bubble sort, and selection sort. We'll analyze the efficiency of each of these algorithms, and we are going to represent them visually. Finally, we are going to talk about two more advanced sorting algorithms, merge sort and quick sort. At the end of this course, you'll have a good understanding of the popular search algorithms and the way they can be implemented using Swift. As the first part of a series on Swift programming, this course is an essential stepping stone for delving deeper into algorithms, data structures, and programming in general. This course is beginner-friendly. Prior programming experience may be helpful, but you need not have actually worked with Swift itself. To implement the exercises in this course, you will need a Mac with El Capitan or Sierra. El Capitan is required because Xcode 8 won't install on prior versions of macOS. You'll also need Xcode 8 or newer. You can download Xcode for free from the Mac App Store. We are going to use modern Swift to implement the source code in this course. Swift 3.0 has brought fundamental changes and language refinements. All the samples were written with the new standard in mind. I am going to update the source code as changes in the language make it necessary. The projects are available on GitHub, and you can download them from the following repository. The Swift programming language is available as open source. Visit swift.org for everything Swift related. Also, you can visit my website laka.com, where you can find many Swift related articles and video tutorials. In the next section, we are going to talk about the Big O notation and we'll analyze the efficiency of algorithms.